Dave from Clean Pro Supply. We're here on a tile cleaning job right now, and I want to show you some basics of just hard surface cleaning, ceramic tile cleaning. This one is actually pretty rough. You can see the floor. I already sprayed it a little bit here, but some of the grout lines are pretty dark, and the actual grout is like a tannish color. So the first thing we're going to talk about is chemistry. Our go-to product is Shorebest 2790, diluted at about 10 ounces per gallon. If using a pump sprayer or an electric sprayer or a mop out of a bucket, that would be ideal for that. I personally use a hydrophore sprayer for doing larger areas because it just goes further and it's easier. The only thing you have to be careful of is the overspray when you're using a hydrophore sprayer. So depending on the dilution and how you have it set, if you have the yellow tip in here, that's going to be 1:8. You're going to do 4 quarts of 2790, 1 quart of water, shake it around. Preferably use warm water through your truck mount or your portable or water otter, water hog, whatever. That will make about 12 gallons of spray by the time you deplete the jug. If you have the yellow tip removed, that's going to be a dilution ratio of 1:4. At that point, you're going to want to do 2 gallons of 2790, 3 gallons of water, and that'll dilute it out and make about 6 gallons total of pre-spray. So I already sprayed this section, but I'm going to hit it again real quick just for demonstration purposes, kind of get ahead of myself before I want to make this video. I always start furthest away. We bring in our solution line, start spraying in a far corner, and go back and forth and pull the solution line out. That way we're not walking all over it as we pull out. And then if we scrub, you know, we scrub in, pull out, and then when we clean, we start cleaning by the door and clean inwards. That way we're not dragging our clean hoses through the muck and the pre-spray and all that. Because of course, you know, on another job, we may have to have those hoses on someone's carpet, dragging across clean carpet if we're not cleaning a certain room. So we don't want to be tracking that all over the place. So we just start spraying from the furthest point towards the door, and then when we clean from the door inward to the furthest point. A little bit different from carpet cleaning. One thing you do have to be careful of is along the edges, the baseboards, cabinets. You don't want to get them wet. If it's MDF, you can cause damage. It'll swell out really bad. So these are all real wood, so we don't have to worry about the swelling. But we still want to be careful because there's a wood finish on there. We don't want that to come off. 2790 is a very potent product. It works really good. Sometimes too good, you know, for certain applications if we don't want to cause any damage to stain, paint, whatever. It is pretty rare, but just something you have to be cautious about. So when I'm spraying personally, what I like to do is, I don't know if you can see my spray pattern here, but I'll keep about 4 inches from the wall. This is the speed I go at. And you can see from me pre-spraying earlier, it's already kicking out some of the dirt. But when I'm going, you know, I keep about 4 inches away. The reason for that is I don't want to get overspray onto the baseboard or onto the carpet. So by keeping that spray 4 maybe 6 inches away, then I can take this brush, it's just a yellow Unger brush from Home Depot, and then I can push it towards the wall like this, and then just go back and forth towards the wall, back and forth, and look at that, just an easy scrub like that without even rinsing, that grout looks new. I didn't even spray in this section, but I can take my spray, pull it in from other areas, and get in there. Notice we took out the vent cover here so we can get the whole tile. So without even hitting this with our turbo, it's already looking new. What I do is I have a helper go around the edges, use the brush, scrub back and forth. You don't want to go in because then you'll push the chemical into the carpet. We don't want to do that. If you do get a little bit on the wood, you know, we can just wipe it with a towel. It's not a big deal. But once you hit the edges like this, again, always go sideways. Don't ever push it. Like, you can push your chemical into the corner, but then don't wrench it in, just kind of feather it. Doesn't take much, I'm not putting a lot of muscle into it. It's just a light agitation, really just moving the chemical around is all we're doing. And then if you want to use a CRB, here we have the Clean Scrub 10 inch from Carpet Cleaning America. It's the authentic Austrian unit. We've got the brown commercial carpet brushes on here. Now you do have to be precautious because this does not have a sealed casing in the motor. So if you do get water that splashes up inside, it could damage the motor. So I'm not saying that this is a go-to scrubbing machine for hard surface cleaning because of the moisture. I use it. If you use it, great. Just be careful. They do have a different model, the Pro Model 35 and the 45. Those do have the sealed housings, so you can use those in rug wash pits. You know, go all day long splashing water around. They're water resistant. Resistance not. But this works fine on tile like this. So I don't have it plugged in right now, but I generally like to scrub against, like at an angle to the grout lines, or if you want to go with the grout lines, do it like this, but then you'll just have to turn to do the next one. So then you can go across the whole floor like that. And then again, like I said earlier, when you start cleaning, you're going to bring the towel tool from the door in, so that way you're not dragging your hoses all over the muck. So since we already have our hoses on the floor here, what we'll do when we're wrapping them up is we'll just stick a towel around the hose as we're winding it out of the end of the van, and then we'll clean off the solution hoses. So if you guys have any questions, let me know. We'll probably snap another video in a few minutes once we get the turbo going to show you how it cleans. Hey everybody, it's Dave from Clean Pro Supply. We're back here again doing the extraction for the tile job. I'm gonna show you a couple things. This is a good example, actually. We started doing the entryway here. We talked earlier about starting your pre-spray in the far corner and spraying out, wipe off your solution line, and then when you're cleaning, start at your door and clean in. That way you're not dragging your hoses across, you know, pre-spray and dirty floor, and then getting your hoses full of pre-spray. So I stopped at a point here because I want to show you this. This is a prime example of something you want to inspect before doing the job and talk to your client. So you can see on this tile, I'm going to take this off here, just so you can hear me. We have a crack across this tile, and we have some grout that's missing around here. So this is something obviously that was here before. It's a pre-existing condition. Obviously not something that we did. We always want to either take a picture of this if the customer's not home before you start, or just let the customer know during your inspection and on the quote, and you can put it on your invoice that there's, you know, pre-existing cracked tiles, degraded missing grout. Because even if this was like this before, you know, when people aren't really looking at their floor as much until after you clean, they're inspecting it. So they may never have even noticed this before, so we want to let them know, because you don't want the blame to be on you for damage like this. Now, one thing that you do want to keep in mind that you could end up doing is, like, this grout here is still there, but if it's loose, maybe that was like that before all the way across. Once you hit it with your turbo, your vacuum could pull out loose grout. So that's another thing too you have to be careful of, both for your own purpose and also just educating the customer that we have a high power vacuum. It could suck that up into your turbo. So if you do see that, let the customer know in advance that this could happen. Some of this did come up. This was already gone. So it's just a situation the customer is aware of. You just need to create that, you know, education for that customer. So moving on to the actual cleaning part now. We're cleaning at about 850 PSI. I don't want to go too high because of the grout situation like that. You want to go high enough to spin the turbo first. This floor is pretty hammered. You can see how clean this tile is. With the truck mount, we're pulling probably about 190 to 200 degrees in temperature for the heat. If you use a portable, that's not always necessary. You just may need to agitate or scrub a little bit more if you don't have the heat or the pressure. Two ways of extracting tile: use a turbo spinner with a higher pressure, or you can use low pressure. So if your portable machine only goes up to 500 PSI, you can get a 4-jet hard surface wand, and you can do the same thing. You don't need high pressure to do it, but it will be faster, it will be easier, it will burn up quicker. So don't think you have to have a spinner, it just makes your life easier. So if you don't have to have a truck mount, but it is a little easier, and it's a little faster than the portable. So nothing wrong with the portable if that's what you got. If you only have a 500 PSI machine, hard surface wand, it'll do the job no problem. So as we're cleaning here, if you look back, you'll see we started at the door. We're working our way in. We've got our guards here to protect the walls. And then the way I have the hose, it's looped around on the sidewalk. So as we pull in, it'll just unloop itself and go in. We're going to go back to the floor here. And you'll see where the sprinter is. You got the clean grout, and then right in front of it is the dirty grout. So this we sprayed earlier at 2790. We did not scrub. All we did was scrub around the edges, because you want to push it in with the edges, and then we're just turboing the rest, so we're not scrubbing the inside here. And you'll see how good that comes. This grout is pretty bad, so you may have to hit it twice. I always go do a forward and a back, nice and slow, just like carpet clean, do a 50% overlap. It's pretty straightforward. You don't have to worry about, you know, letting go of the trigger or any of that. But you do want to rinse it really good. So forward, back over the same path. It's going to come up, do an overlap, forward and back over the same path. If for some reason you're seeing bubbles or any sort of, you know, what looks like soapy residue, just hit it again. or slow down. You know, some guys will do this, will race through. Yeah, it might look better, but that's not the right way of doing it because you're going to need residue on the floor. Just go nice and steady. If you hit a tough spot, then you can slow down a little bit, work it a little. But again, it's not a race. You're just starting at your door, cleaning in. When you see a wood transition like this, it is okay to go over it. Just in case there's any overspray. Now I'm going to show you something. If you go too fast, it's going to create what some people call tiger stripes. So I went really quick across that line there. You can see it's spotty. It's because the jet was spinning around and you were going too fast. So if you get that, just slow down. There you go. Look how good that's doing. 2790, no scrubbing. 850 PSI. Real easy clean. I could do this all day long. To me, this is much easier than cleaning carpet. And I charge twice as much. So if you're new to hard surface cleaning, if you're nervous about it, if you're scared about it, you know, just reach out for help. It is a great service to have on your, you know, list of services for your customers. Now, just so you see here, I can't get the spinner back in that edge there, so what we'll do is we'll use a hand tool to get back in there around the edge there because the turbo can't get in there. Another thing you can do too, honestly, is just wipe it with a rag, you know, a damp rag, as long as you get all the residue up. That's the main thing. There's nothing wrong with that as long as you clean it. So after we're all done here, we are going to use an edging tool to go around all the edges and corners, just so we wrap it up nice and neat. And that's it. If anybody else has any questions, give me a shout. Dave from Clean Pro Supply. Thanks.